But should those in Scotland, hi Scotland, Northern Ireland, and Wales be cheering on their nearest neighbour, all with a long history of football rivalry, are they actually justified? Is it actually a bit of fun in supporting anyone but England? Scottish line of duty actor Martin Compston may struggle a bit.
Hey mate, just want to say, so happy for you guys. Congratulations. Hope you enjoy this night and that England might have a chance. Static. I'm happy that you're happy.
Definition of gritted teeth, isn't it?
And we're joined now by broadcaster and former editor of the Scottish Sun, Gordon Smart, who would go even further than Martin Compston, because, Gordon, you're happy for England to win tomorrow night and reach the final, and then what do you want to happen?
Well, we used to live together, actually, Martin and I, so that was very well choreographed. Years of practice for this big moment. Of course, we want the pain to be as severe as possible. So, yeah, get through the semi-final, lose on penalties in the final. That's the best result for the two-thirds of the population.
How sadistic is that? That is pure sadism.
Scottish duo The Krankies have a very different view, don't you? Because you're going to saying,
hello.
Come on, England, it's coming home. Morning.
Morning, yes, certainly. We're all for it. We're British and Scottish. Let's see, all stick behind Britain. If it was Wales, if it was Ireland, we're all one. Come on, it's against the Europeans. Yeah. We want to win.
And what do you think of a fellow Scotland fan like Gordon Smart, who says, he wants to see the worst outcome possible, the most painful end to the tournament for England?
I remember Gordon when he was the showbiz editor of the Sun. He wasn't very good at that either.
Boom! Gordon, can you explain it? Just explain the psychology to us, because I was saying on this show about 3 or 4 weeks ago, as the tournament was beginning, I genuinely cheer for Scotland, unless they're playing England, obviously. I genuinely cheer for Scotland. I really want them to win. I remember Archie Gemmell's wonderful goal, 30 years ago, son of Scotland. I genuinely cheer for Wales, genuinely. Why won't you guys cheer for us?
Low self-esteem, rampant paranoia, and good old-fashioned mischief-making, Richard, right? It's about rivalry, right? I've got two teams, Hibernian and Scotland. I'm afraid I don't just then automatically support my nearest geographical neighbour as a result of us going out of a tournament. It's a bit of fun, right? And I need to make it absolutely clear. I think Gareth Southgate's a phenomenal manager and a brilliant diplomat, a great bloke, a wonderful ambassador. And that England team is probably the most likeable England team there has been for a long time. But I still want the journey to end one stop before it gets home. I don't want it to come home.
What's interesting, though, is that you don't feel kind of any guilt at all about the fact that we do, most people in this country, the vast majority of people, when I say this country, I mean England, most people in England do support Scotland. It doesn't make you feel in any way guilty that you extract the mickey, if I can put it that way, out of us.
You just tripped yourself up there, Mr. Madeley,
yes,
by
I
saying
did, didn't
this
I?
Country, didn't
yes,
you?
You're absolutely so right. I fell right into it, yeah.
It's precisely that accidental jingoism of the microphone that causes the trouble. It's Boris Johnson when he said, I hope all the other nations who are involved in this do well as well. Yeah. It's that kind of stuff that just rubs us up the wrong way. And look, it's just a bit of fun. For me, it's this half and half scarf culture that doesn't quite work for me. You support two teams, that's the end of it. I like the England team. I think they're a decent bunch, but I don't want it. Imagine how painful it will be for us, right? We've already had the Gaza goal from 96 played back to us every 15 seconds for the last 6 weeks. Yes. If you win it, I mean, listen, I've taken next week off work, so I'm not in England. I'm going to go as far north as possible. I'll be in Speyside. Because I can't cope with it, right?
It's
just a bit of fun.
Can I just say, in my own defence, I am half Scottish. My mother was a McEwen, so that was just a slip of the tongue.
Oh, you are literally a half and half scarf man, aren't you, Richard?
Yeah, definitely.
Ian and Jeanette. Susanna,
may I just respond to that little jibe from the Krankies as well? They were very quick and very happy to take some payment from me to appear in the Scottish Sun when I was the showbiz editor, and they're spending it all in gin and tonic in Australia
that.
Now.
No, Matt Bendoris is my man in the Scottish Sun.
So I signed off his expenses, Ian.
I feel like there's history here that we don't want to delve into. Ian-